Hello everyone, I am Pratibha Ghosh and here I am discussing about the chapter When, Where and How. It is a very important chapter for the CTET paper 2 social science and also for the aspirants who were preparing for other competitive exams. Now let's start the chapter. When, Where and How. When means कब, where means कहा, how means कैसे. Now all these three words notify us about an event that has occurred over time, so as history. History is the study of our past that informs us about the changes which occur over time. इसका मतलब यह है कि हिस्ट्री हमें यह बताता है कि पास्ट में कैसा था और अभी प्रेजेंट में वह कितना चेंजेस हो गया है, उसमें कितना बदलाव आया है. नाउ दिस वर्ड हिस्ट्री केम फ्रॉम एन एंशियंट ग्रीक वर्ड मीनिंग नॉलेज फ्रॉम inquiry. Now coming to the next slide, why do we need to study history? History पढ़ने की हमें क्या ज़रूरत है, क्यों हम history पढ़ते हैं? History gives us a better understanding of the lifestyle of the people who lived before us. हमारे पहले जो पूर्वज रह के गए हैं उनका lifestyle कैसा था. So the study of the past we understand the present better. Past के बारे में हम जितना जानेंगे उतना ही हम present situation को अच्छी तरह से समझ पाएंगे. History helps us to understand the events that are happening in the world today. History यानी इतिहास हमें इस चीज में भी सहायता करती है कि हम लोग जो पृथ्वी पर हो रहे इवेंट्स को अच्छी तरह से समझ पाए. नाउ टू बिगिन द स्टडी ऑफ हिस्ट्री फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू नो द टाइम फ्रेम. सो कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड, डेट्स इन हिस्ट्री. ऑल डेट्स बिफोर द बर्थ ऑफ क्राइस्ट आर काउंटेड बैकवर्ड्स, दैट इज इन descending order, and dates after Christ are counted in ascending order. So BC stands for before Christ, that is counted in descending order. AD stands for Anno Domini, counted in ascending order. And the word Anno Domini is a Latin word which means the year of the Lord. CE stands for common era, and this word CE used sometimes in place of AD. Now coming to the next slide, periodization of Indian history. The main purpose of the periodization is to capture characteristics of a time and its central features. Different terms were used to periodize or demarcate periods. It reflects the ideas about past. It also throws light upon the significance of change from one period to next. In 1817, a Scottish economist and political philosopher, James Mills, published an enormous 3-volume work, namely A History of British India. In this work, he divided the history of India into 3 parts, Hindu, Muslim and British. James Mills ने अपनी किताब A History of British India में भारत के इतिहास को 3 हिस्सों में विभाजित किया था. जेम्स मिल्स ने ऐसा इसलिए किया था क्योंकि उन्होंने सोचा था कि ब्रिटिश भारत में आने से पहले सिर्फ हिंदू और मुस्लिम रूलर ही इंडिया में रूल करते थे, यानी भारत में अपना शासन चलाते थे। बट दिस डिवीजन वॉज प्रूवन रॉन्ग बाय सम इंडियन हिस्टोरियंस बिकॉज अदर रिलीजियंस लाइक बुद्धिज्म, जैनिज्म एंड सिखिज्म वेर ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट एट दैट टाइम। So later, some Western historians divided the period of Indian history into ancient, medieval, and modern history on the occurrence of the period. This division reflects the correct idea of the past exactly the way it borrowed in the history. They believe that modern thought in India came with the coming of British, so they call British era as modern type. अब हमें यह पता चल गया है कि इंडियन हिस्ट्री को पीरियडिकली 3 पार्ट्स में डिवाइड किया गया है, एंशियंट, मीडियवल एंड मॉडर्न। अब हम नेक्स्ट स्लाइड पर आते हैं, सोर्सेस ऑफ इंडियन हिस्ट्री। सोर्सेस यानी एविडेंसेस, क्या क्या एविडेंसेस है इंडियन हिस्ट्री के। द एविडेंसेस दैट रिलेट टू ओरिजिन ऑफ अर्लीस्ट सिविलाइजेशन, देयर कल्चर्स, देयर बिलीफ्स कैन बी ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम द सोर्सेस अवेलेबल अबाउट इंडियस हिस्ट्री। बेसिकली देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ सोर्सेस, that is literary sources and archaeological sources. Literary sources includes the earliest writings which were written by hands on palm leaves or on specially prepared bark of a tree called birch, which is known as manuscripts. And also there are many literary sources like religious literature, non-religious literature, written records of rulers, written records of foreign travelers. इनको हम डिटेल में भी पढ़ेंगे। Now coming to the archaeological sources, it includes inscriptions, coins, seals and monuments. Now coming to the next slide, literary sources. It includes earliest writings, handwritten records, written on palm leaves, barks of a tree called birch, which is known as manuscripts. Indian literary sources were written in Sanskrit, Pali, and Prakrit language, and also in South India the sources are found in Tamil and Telugu language. Some written records are not in any script but they are in the form of pictures and drawings. Now coming to the next slide, manuscripts. Here are some pictures of manuscripts which are written on the palm leaves. These are very old manuscripts. Now coming to the next slide, that is religious records. It includes Vedas, Upanishads, Puranas and religious writings of Jains and Buddhists like Dipvamsa and Mahavamsa. Next slide is non-religious records, which include Kautilya's Arthashastra, Kalidasa's Malvikagnimitram, Kalhan's Rajtarangini, Nayachandra's Hamirkavya, grammar of Panini, and many more. Now coming to the next slide, Ramayana and Mahabharata are both religious and non-religious text. Another type of literary sources are written records of rulers, which include Babanama, Banbhattas, Harshacharita, etc. Written records of foreign travelers, which includes Indica, written by Megasthenes, Siyuki, it is the record of Western countries, written by Wensang, Rihala, written by Ibn Battuta, Kitabul Hind, written by Al-Biruni, and also some records of Buddhist countries are available, which are written by Fahien, and some geographic records which are written by Ptolemy, etc. Now coming to the archaeological sources, these evidences are obtained by the systematic and skilled examination of building monuments and work of art. This includes material remains. Many of those sources are buried underground and have to be dug out or excavated. The people who study the tools, weapons, and other remains of the past are known as archaeologists. Now coming to the next slide, the credit for excavating the pre-Aryan evidences goes to Sir William Jones, who established Asiatic Society of Bengal on 1st January 1784. Sir Alexander Cunningham excavated the ruins of ancient sites of pre-Aryan culture. Alexander Cunningham is known as the father of Indian archaeology. Coming to the next slide, inscriptions. These are the most reliable evidences and their study is called epigraphy. These are mostly carved on gold, silver, iron, copper, bronze plates, stone pillars, rock temple walls, and are free from interpolations. Most of the inscriptions in India are in Brahmi and Kharosthi scripts. James Prinsep, the secretary of Asiatic Society of Bengal, succeeded for the first time in deciphering the Brahmi script. Inscriptions are mainly of three types: royal eulogy, official documents, private records. So coming to the next slide, here is a picture given, that is Ashokan inscription. Now coming to the next slide, coins. The study of coins is known as numismatics. Ancient coins were made of gold, silver, copper, or lead. Thousands of ancient Indian coins have been discovered, from which idea about the contemporary economic condition, currency system, development of metallurgical art has been obtained. This gives us a lot of information about the ruler, the period he she ruled, trade, interests of the rulers, and economic conditions of that time. Some pictures of the coins are given here. Now coming to the next slide, monuments. Monuments are historical buildings. This provides us with visual evidences of the lives of the people of earlier times. This also provides us the information about the materials used, the influence of other cultures on Indian people of the past, the economic condition of the empire, and religious beliefs prevalent in those times. Some examples of monuments are Sanchi Stupa, Hawa Mahal, Taj Mahal, etc. So some pictures of some monuments are given here. Next slide is about seals. Seals are stamps or engravings set in stone or metal. These are important sources of knowledge about the people of those civilizations. Here some pictures of seals are given. Now coming to the next slide, sources of information of the colonial period. The sources used by historians in writing about the last 250 years of Indian history are survey, official records, newspapers and literature. The practice of surveying also became common under the colonial administration. The British believed that a country had to be properly known before it could be effectively administered. By the early 19th century, detailed surveys were being carried out to map the entire country. Official records were compiled by officials working for British government. The British believed that the act of writing was important. Every instructions, plan, policy decision, agreement, investment had to be clearly written up. Newspapers become very common after the invention of printing. Many newspapers in the vernacular medium were popular among the people. These newspapers give us a glimpse of the common life and culture. Moreover, the forms of popular literature like novels and religious discourses also give us rich information about that period. Now coming to the next slide. A term is given here, that is archive. An archive is a place where historical manuscripts and documents are kept. Moving to the next slide, need to preserve historical sources. Preservation of historical sources is very important. The study of history is only possible if we preserve historical sources. Hum itihas tabhi bar payenge jab hum historical sources ko preserve karke rakhenge. History helps us to understand the cultures. They provide a connection to our past. History hame hamare past ke saath connect karne mein help karta hai. This help in generating revenue. Historical monuments ke wajah se kafi foreigners aur bahut sare log wahan ghumne jaate hain, jiske wajah se hamare country mein bahut sare revenue generate hote hain. Hope you all like this video. Thank you for watching.